I am engineer Abdul Karim, the project manager for constructing three railway bridges with their approaches and extending a railway line between Hijama, Sawah, Samawa in central Iraq.
Dear ones, I will try to summarize the paragraphs of this bridge for you through this video.
The bridge foundation consists of a number of pillars of different diameters according to their location in the bridge, which are dug with a special machine to depths of up to 30 or 25 meters from the riverbed. Then, the reinforcing steel mesh is inserted according to the maps to these depths, and then the concrete is added. After completing the pouring of these pillars, their upper ends are broken to be connected to the reinforcing steel of the pile cap to form a concrete cast that represents the foundation of the columns that will be built on them, by connecting them as well to the reinforcing steel of the pile cap. Then comes the stage of pouring the column, which are called pier over each pile cap, as well as pouring the head of this pier, which called pier cap, so that the girder can sit on them, where the bearing pad are placed between them and the head of the pier.
Welcome, my dears, to the two-lane railway bridge website. This is one of the pillar caps of this bridge at the bottom of the Euphrates River in Samawa in central Iraq. Dear sir, the volume of concrete used for this cap is 700 cubic meters, and the required concrete compressive strength is 30 newton/square millimeter.
The forms of the girders used in this bridge, which amount to 48 girders, with dimensions of 40 by 3 meters and a weight of 180 tons, are being installed. After completing these girders, the strand is inserted and pulled according to the specifications. After completing these girders, the strand is inserted in the required quantity of 5 bundles of pulling wires with a diameter of 15.7 millimeters, and pulled according to the specifications. After that, the girders are ready for installation. This is a large girder which is being implemented for the first time in the Iraqi railways. The process of operating the beam launcher and providing the appropriate working environment made the process of installing the girder a strenuous task, especially because of the high winds that affect the balance of the beam launcher, as it must be light in speed. As you can see, this is a 200-ton beam launcher, specially made in China to be able to lift the girder weighing 180 tons. Its parts were assembled on site and, as you can see, it is being carried on a large carrier to the bridge site.